Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Mountain Grove Church for the 2003 presentation of Christmas at the Mountain.
Christmas. Christmas to remember. Sweetheart, it looks like we're going to be by ourselves this year for Christmas. I sure do miss having little kids around all the time.
I know. But the kids will be home for Christmas dinner.
I know, but it's just not the same as having them around all the time. You're seeing the anticipation in their eyes. Look at these kids, how excited they are. I miss them climbing up on my lap and singing silly little Christmas songs with me.
Maybe some of these kids would like to sing a song.
Joy, 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 joy.
sweetheart, it's getting late, and I know you're getting cold, so let's go home.
Sweetheart, it's the beggar at me.
Hi, my name is Mary. Can I take a
look? Hi, Mary.
I would love to get a cat, too.
Okay, can you read?
The cat coffee, please. So, what's a beggar?
The beggar at the inn, 2,000 years ago, in the Jewish town of Bethlehem, on a cold winter's night, a beggar came to the door of the only inn in the town to see if he could find some food and a place to sleep.
Sleep already, man. What's going on with you?
Yes, I just need something to eat and perhaps someone warm to sleep.
The way you're dressed, it's apparent you have no money. No money means no food, no lodging. Look, these are hard times. The census is going on. Caesar Augustus has all uproar. The whole place is going crazy. People are coming in from everywhere. We're full. We have no last money.
Just something to eat then, please.
Take this bread and go away. Leave me alone.
Just somewhere warm to sleep in. It's too cold, please.
You're becoming a nuisance.
Yes.
Sit right here. The fireplace is on the other side. It'll keep you warm. It's the best place I have for you. Do not bother anyone or I have you thrown out of here. Sit down and be quiet. Here, take this blanket. Do not bother anyone.
It's got a blanket.
For before they were married, God's Spirit came upon Mary, and she became pregnant with a baby, who was, by the angel's decree, to be the Son of God, Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus. Well, they were married, and soon they got the word about the census. That's when they count the people. Though she was going to have a baby, the young couple journeyed to Bethlehem from Nazareth to pay their taxes. They arrived that same dark night.
There's no room at the inn. I only tried. And that innkeeper, he isn't very helpful.
Thank you for the information, sir. But my wife is expecting soon, and we've got to get her out of this cold.
Go away, we have no rooms! Doesn't anybody know what census is going on?
Told you.
Sir, we really need a place to stay. My wife's expecting. Soon.
Expecting? Expecting what?
Oh, she's expecting. And soon.
Yes, sir. Is there no way you can help us?
Son, I'm sorry.
The rooms are full. Everyone's gone to bed already. I don't have anything left.
Well, I do.
No.
No, sir. No, please.
I have the stable. It can provide a little bit of shelter, but that's about all I have for you.
Thank you, sir. We'll take it.
Hold on one second. Follow me. Take these blankets, wrap her up with you tonight. It'll keep her a little bit warm. Here's a lamp. You can light it. It'll give you a little bit of light. I'm sorry. It's all I have for you.
Thank you, sir. May God bless you for your travels.
That's fine. You have a good night now.
Thank you again.
You're welcome. I thought I told you to leave everyone alone.
I thought you said you didn't have any place for me to sleep.
I was afraid your stench would scare my animals.
Oh.
Same night, Mary brought forth her firstborn son. And though both Mary and Joseph knew that this was God's son, they still could not contain the great emotions of joy and love.
Into these harmonies, your prophet. see. Can you believe that we're going to see the Savior of the world? The first deception, the Messiah. All this talk in the old scriptures, and we
now we've got
read.
To spread the word.
We've got to tell people.
Other people heard about Jesus too, not from the shepherds and the angels,
but from the prophets who had written about his arrival many years before. It took a couple of years, but they had followed the sign of the star to the place where the child was.
Sir! Sir!
What do you want?
I need some information.
Information? Well, what kind of information?
I need to know where someone is.
Guess what? Who is it?
The child who has been born King of the Jews.
Yes, King of the Jews. Wait a second. I thought Herod was the king.
Well, we went to Jerusalem inquiring about this king, and he told us to come to Bethlehem. We've been traveling nonstop for days.
How did you get here?
We've been following that star.
Star? But, oh, cool! It's amazing. I remember a couple of years ago, some shepherds came looking for a baby. They called him Messiah or Lord. I'm not sure this is the same kid.
Oh, yes.
Well, I know where he and his family live. I can take you there. It'll cost you.
Oh, no problem.
How did you hear about this, Messiah, the Lord, or...
Well,
or did...
my masters are waiting on me at the edge of town. Yes. Hurry, show me.
Oh, yes, certainly, come, please. This way, Lisa lives there. Yeah. I don't know what's so special about this child, but I like it.
Shines for all who choose to see.
is so special about this child? I've seen other fathers hold their new sons, and Joseph, he seems to hold them differently, tenderly. And I've seen other mothers so full of joy at the birth of their firstborn. And Mary, as well, but she seemed to even carry him with a different purpose. And then the shepherds, seeking a baby and talking about angels, and it all seems so special. I don't know, a miracle of sorts. And then the wise men, coming from so far away, and yet they came, and following a star, and bowing down before a young child. I've never bowed down before anyone or anything. Still, I wish I could see what they see. I wish I could understand. Maybe I'll go back for one more look. Maybe then I'll see it. Maybe.
Hallelujah.
allowed me to witness the birth of your son. And you sent those shepherds to bear witness of the miracle. And the wise men to show me the majesty of your plan. And you've allowed me to follow in the same footsteps of his path here to the end of myself, leaving me only with Jesus. Suddenly myself doesn't seem so important anymore. I feel so much love from you. Oh, thank you. I bear witness to your glory. I've come to see the filth that is myself. God, I choose to bow down. I choose to bow down. Father, will you place your righteousness within me so that I can know your fullness? I believe this child is your son, and I trust in your plan, just as those shepherds told me. I make you my Lord. You are God's glory, his only son, the brightest morning. Alpha and Omega, Ancient of Days, we cry, worthy, worthy is your name. And I tremble just to think you know my